Hello and welcome back to Moving to Madison. It's Dayna here, your relocation agent, and I am so excited today to start breaking down some neighborhoods to you. So we are going to focus on one neighborhood in particular, and that is the Monroe Street neighborhood. I think once you learn about this neighborhood, you'll be like, no wonder she picked that one as her first one. It's absolutely so cute, has the best little shops and restaurants in it and the best combination of styled homes in it. It's a really cool neighborhood. A little bit of something for everyone. So let's dive in. We will explore today the style of homes, average tax prices, local businesses, cafes, shops, and other amenities that Monroe Street has to provide. It's a very unique and vibrant community. Monroe Street is a picturesque and highly sought after neighborhood in Madison, Wisconsin. It's known for its blend of historical charm and modern conveniences. It is located near University of Madison, near the campus. Now, not all students live over there because it's like on the other side of the campus. A lot more students live over by State Street, towards downtown, towards the east side of campus. But it is a very friendly atmosphere for students, and it is also very community oriented for families. There are just as many families living there as there are students. One of the standout features of Monroe Street is its diverse range of housing options. You'll find a mix of architectural styles from classic bungalows and colonial homes to more contemporary designs. The neighborhood boasts tree-lined streets and well-maintained properties, making it a really visual, appealing place to call home. I absolutely love the variety of homes there. I mean, price range, architectural style. I mean, they're all so different, and that's so refreshing because as neighborhoods are being built up on the outskirts of Madison, the suburban neighborhood feel, everything looks the same. Here in the Monroe Street area, everything looks very different. Now let's talk about taxes. In Madison, property taxes can vary depending on factors such as the size of your home and the value of your home. On average, property taxes in Monroe Street can range from the lower end of $3,000 to the higher end of $6,000 plus annually, but it's essential that you consult with me about what your price range is for your home and your taxes, because yes, Monroe Street is known to have a higher tax bracket than other areas of Madison. So that's definitely something we want to make sure. Yeah, just because you can afford a house doesn't mean that with taxes and homeowners insurance, everything on top of that, we want to make sure that you're really in the price range, the type of budget that you need to be for your home. Let's talk about local businesses on Monroe Street. This area is a vibrant hub of activity, and it has a variety of local businesses, cafes, and also shops to shop at. You can start your day with a cup of coffee at one of the cozy cafes. My two favorite are either Collectivo or Bloom Bakery. And if you go to Bloom Bakery, you for sure will be getting a piece of bakery with your coffee. My absolute favorite are their sweet potato donuts. You have to try them. You'll also find really cute boutique stores, ones where they're great for getting gifts for people or to buy clothing for yourself. Antique shops, there's Strictly Discs where you can buy records and CDs, things like that. There's also a local bookstore called Mystery to Me. Big shout out to them. Support your local bookstore. You'll also find the fan favorite for so many people who don't even live on Monroe Street is... why am I blanking on this grocery store's name? Trader Joe's. It's Trader Joe's. People love Trader Joe's. And it's like right in the middle, in the most busiest part of Monroe Street, right across from Bloom Bakery. And the parking's actually a little wonky. But if you're a diehard Trader Joe's fan, that is where you're headed. It's the only one in Madison. You have to go there. It's really fun to walk around Monroe Street. And if you are a foodie and you're craving a treat, there are so many good dining options. There's Pizza Bruta. There's Mickey's Dairy Bar, which is, I would say, more of a college favorite. It's the, like, you had a late night and you want some greasy diner food in the morning. It's absolutely delicious. It's iconic. You always see a line of people out the door waiting. Doesn't matter what the weather is. Yay, Wisconsin. There's Indian places called Taste of India. That is down the road on Monroe Street, closer to other amazing restaurants like Everly and Gates and Brovey. Huge shout out to Gates and Brovey. They have absolutely delicious food. I just, the atmosphere is amazing. The brunch is amazing. And also their fish fry is really good. And if you're first coming to Wisconsin and you haven't tried a fish fry yet, actually, maybe I should do another video on that. But you can get that at Gates and Brovey. It's amazing. So for outdoor enthusiasts, just off of Monroe Street, very close to Gates and Brovey and Everly, those restaurants there, Taste of India, is Wingra Park. And it's such a beautiful park. It's really big and spacious. It's amazing for picnics. It's amazing for, you know, laying your blanket out, bringing some food during the summer. And then there's Wingra Boats, where you can actually rent paddle boards, kayaks, canoes, those floaty things, or the, what's it like with the family if you have kids? Paddle boat, just a paddle boat. And you can go on Lake Wingra, and it's amazing because it's a smaller lake. You know, we're surrounded by lakes, Lake Monona, Lake Mendota. Those are huge. Lake Wingra is a smaller lake that if you go really far from Wingra Park, you could end up in Lake Monona. But you don't want to do that because you have to pay $50 if you need to get rescued. I'm pretty sure it's still $50. I always got nervous. One thing that my husband and I love doing is paddleboarding there. But if it's a windy day, I'm always very careful to paddle into the wind when I have like the energy to do that, and then let the wind take me back to where you like return the paddleboard again. So Lake Wingra is a huge highlight of the Monroe Street neighborhood. It's so cute. But there's also really good walking trails throughout the neighborhood, kind of weaved in between the homes and like going over a cute little bridge. And now that I'm thinking about it, it's close to fall right now. I can't wait for the leaves to fall off all of those very mature trees in that neighborhood and to walk around there. So I'm going to have to do that. It's very scenic. If you are moving to Madison and you have kids or are planning on having a family, you'll be pleased to know that Monroe Street is close to some very excellent schools, and you have the option of both public and private. There's Wingra School, Crescendo Preschool, there's Edgewood High School, there's the Madison Public School System, plenty of schools over there. And there's also a lot of cool options for your kids for after-school programs or during the summer, different camps. Monroe Street Art Center is a really amazing place to send your kids where they can take art classes, they can learn music. There's just so many things that they offer there. And that is just down from Trader Joe's. It's very neat. Another really cool family option, if you're in the Monroe Street neighborhood, is to visit the Henry Vilas Zoo, which is actually completely free. You don't have to pay to enter. It's like the cutest zoo, totally my style. Like, I don't want to go to a really huge one. It's like you can just pop over there. There's the Vilas Park too. And there's actually even a little beach there, which during the summer is really fun. I've been there before during the summer when like nobody else is there. It's really awesome. So pop over to the Henry Vilas Zoo. And if you go on the weekend, just know there'll be a crowd. It's pretty busy because it's just such a cool offering that Madison offers. So in conclusion, Monroe Street in Madison, Wisconsin offers a wonderful blend of housing options, a really tight-knit community, diverse businesses, and recreational opportunities. It's a neighborhood with a lot to offer, making it a very attractive place to live for a wide range of residents. If you have more questions about this neighborhood or a different neighborhood in particular as you are making your move to Madison, Wisconsin, all of my information is in the description below. I would be so happy to connect with you and help you in any way I can on your move to Madison as you are looking for a house to buy. And if you want to learn more about walkable neighborhoods, I have done a video about that. You can find that here. Just click on the link. And I'm really excited for you. I'm excited for you to learn more about Madison, Wisconsin, and to decide where is it that you want to live. Investing in a home is a big deal. And I want you to be able to land on your feet in a neighborhood that you love. So if it is the Monroe Street neighborhood, put it in the comments below. Like this video. I would like to connect with you. Thank you so much. And until next time. Bye.